Welcome back, friends. Dan Vega here, and today we are going to be building a streaming chatbot with Spring Boot and Spring AI. Now, why would we want to do that? Well, if you go over to something like ChatGPT and you type out a query, so write me a short overview of machine learning, you immediately start getting some feedback, like the LLM is processing that response, generating some text, and sending it back to you. You wouldn't want to wait for that entire response to come back to you before it's displayed in the UI. That would not be very user-friendly, right? You'd be sitting there waiting, wondering if something's going on, when in fact it was. So my mission today is to make sure you understand just how easy this is to do in Spring AI, like most things. And we're going to go through a fun little tutorial to kind of walk through this. Now, here I am over at this repo, github.com/DanVega, Spring AI streaming. This will contain all of the source code that we're going to go through today. Has a nice README in there that you can go through if you want to understand what we're going to do today, as well as some templates, because we could build out the back end and just kind of call this via Postman, curl, HTTP IE. And that would be sufficient enough to kind of show off the Spring AI side, right? But what I wanted to do was add some UI to this. Let's take a look at what happens when we wait for that whole response, and then how we can add some streaming data into that. So this is the repo that we're going to go through. I am going to be using Anthropic 3's Claude Sonnet 3.5 as the LLM. Now, this will work with whatever LLM you're choosing. So if you want to use something different, like OpenAI or Google Gemini, feel free to do so. The code will be the same. That's one of the highlights of Spring AI, is it gives you this portable chat completion, right? Whatever LLM we're talking to, the code is going to be the same. And one of the many, many reasons I love Spring AI. So that's the repo. That is the LLM that we're talking to today. How can we get this started? So we're going to head over to start.spring.io. I'm going to fill in some metadata. Let's say dev.danvega. We'll call this streaming, and we'll spell that right. I'm using Java 23. Feel free to use whatever you want. I'm going to create a web app. Now, the only downside to this particular demo is that Anthropic's Claude is not available in the Spring Initializer, but it is available in Spring AI. So what I like to do is just choose something like OpenAI. That will give us all the bits that we need because, again, it sets a couple of things in here. It says, hey, here's the version of Spring AI. It also pulls in that dependency management, says that we're using a Spring milestone. So we could go ahead and copy and paste all that in. But what I'm going to do is use OpenAI and just change that over to Anthropic's starter. So with that, I think we have everything we need. What we're going to do is generate a new zip. We'll go ahead and download this as a zip file. You can open it up in whatever text editor or IDE you're most productive in. For me, that's going to be IntelliJ Ultimate Edition. Nothing special in there that we're doing, I don't think, at least of today. So you can use whatever you'd like. But with that, I think we have everything we need. So what are we waiting for? Let's write some code. All right, so here I am in the application. The first thing we're gonna do is, again, make a small change there. Instead of bringing in OpenAI, I am going to bring in the Anthropic Spring Boot starter that is coming from springframework.ai. So all I'm gonna do is go ahead and reload that. Now, the next thing I need to do is in my application.properties, we're going to have to add a couple of things. I will go ahead and paste this in. But we're going to set our API key. This you can get through the Anthropic's console. I went ahead and externalized this into an environment variable so I don't leak my credentials. And then I go ahead and set the model. So I want to use the latest Claude 3.5 Sonnet model. So I declare that in there. There is a default. If you look in the documentation, you can see what that is. You can see what the other options are if you want to choose another model, or if you're watching this in the future and there's an update, you can go ahead and grab that one. Now, if you're using a different LLM, maybe you're using OpenAI, there are similar properties for that LLM where you got to set an API key. Maybe you want to set the model to like GPT-4.0. You can do the same. This is the only difference when we're talking about switching LLMs, is the properties that we set here. The code that we write is going to be the same for whatever LLM we're talking to. So with that out of the way, we have what we need to get started. Now, I'm going to serve up a HTML file. And the way I can do that without using any kind of templating engine is to drop some HTML files in the static folder. So I'm going to start with an index, and that will be the root. So if I say index.html, this is the root of the project. So when I start the application, localhost 8080, this is going to be served up. So we're using a couple things here in this one. We're going to use HTMX. We're going to use Tailwind. Again, things I like to do. You don't absolutely need this here. You can send a full request to the server and get it back. But this works out well. So in my chatbot, I have this kind of pre-div and then pre where I'm going to load in the chat messages. I have this input box all the way at the bottom of the page, similar to a chatbot that you've probably seen online, and where we type our message in. When I post this, I'm going to send a request to slash chat. And then what we'll do is when we get the response back, we have an HX target of chat messages, which is this. That's where the chat will, or the response will get sent to. And then we just have a submit button. We have a little bit of HTMX on. So after our request, we're just clearing out that chatbot, that input field to kind of reset it back to, hey, type your message. So pretty simple layout here, but I want to kind of show off just the normal, hey, let's send a request, get back the response, wait for the entire response to come back, and then display that in the UI. So to do that, I'm going to create a class here. We're going to call this chat controller. And this is going to be our chat controller that takes in a request, talks to the LLM, and then returns the response. So we are going to make this a REST controller. We are going to create a, the first thing that we need is access to the chat client. So I'll say chat client, that comes from Spring AI. Again, this is universal no matter what LLM we're using. So we get to use the same code for each. So we are going to get this through the builder. I'm gonna go ahead and call this builder, and then I'll just say builder.build. If I wanted to, I can go ahead and set some other options, like I can set a default system prompt, I can set some advisors, some functions, a default user message, whatever I wanted to do, I can set here. I don't need to do that for this one though. We're just gonna create a simple method that we can take in a chat request. So this is going to be a post mapping because, again, on the front end, we're sending this through a post request. And we'll send this to slash chat. And then I'll say public string chat. This is going to take in a request param, which is going to be the message that the user types in. And then I can say, let's just return that chat client. And I can say, I want to send a prompt. The message is going to be whatever that user types in. We're going to call the LLM, and then what I want back is just the string content. That's it. That is Spring AI's fluent API, an easy way to go ahead and call an LLM and get a response. So let's look at this. Let's go ahead and try and run our application here. Hopefully it starts up okay. Go back to the UI here, and so we get Dan's chatbot. This is where the response is going to be, and this is where our message is. And I'll type in my favorite message, tell me a dad joke about dogs, and enter. And there we go, we got a response. Here's a dog-related dad joke for you. Why don't dogs make good dancers? Because they have two left feet. Ah, good one, good one. Now, that was a short one. Let's go ahead and refresh this. Let's ask a message that might send back a little bit longer of a response. So write me a short overview of machine learning. So I hit enter. Now we're waiting. Sure, we could put some indicator up, some spinner going on that we're thinking about a response. But we just wait, and then we get a response back that says, you know, here it is. Types of machine learning, key concepts, etc. So again, not a very good user experience. Like I want to know something's going on, but I also don't need to wait for the entire response. I have a lot to read here, so if you start sending me back data, I can start reading it while you're generating the response. And that's what we're going to do here. We're going to kind of fix this up. So I'm going to go ahead and hit stop for a second on our application. And I want to show you just how easy it is to add streaming support here. So what we're going to do is we're going to do something similar, but I'm going to add a Git mapping because on our front end, we're going to end up just calling this Git request and getting the data as it comes back. And let's go ahead and map this to /stream. So the difference here is instead of returning a string, we are going to return a flux of strings. And again, flux and mono come from the Reactor project, Spring Web Flux. This is kind of included. Spring AI brings this in for you. So we're saying, hey, we need to go ahead and return a flux of strings. And we'll say chat with stream. And then again, this is going to take in a request param. And this is going to be called message. And we're going to return the chat client just like we did before. We're going to prompt. We're going to say, hey, the user message is this message that is passed in. But instead of call, we're just going to call stream. And you see that has a stream that takes in a stream response spec. But we're going to return, all we're going to return from that is content again. Content. And that's it. So it looks pretty similar to the one above. There's not a lot going on here. It's a nice fluent API. But again, calling stream, now we can get the return type of flux of stream and start to get that content back. Now, let's go ahead and run this. We're going to build a UI for this in a second. But I want to show this off. This is much easier to show off in something like Postman or HTTP IE. So from the terminal, I can use my handy dandy HTTP tool. This is just a client being able to test this. But in HTTP IA, you can say this is going to be a stream. I'm getting a stream of data back. And what I'm going to call is 8080/stream. And the message that I'm going to send is tell me a story about pirates. I love a good story about pirates. We're going to hit enter, and as we start to get data, it's going to start sending it back. Here's the curse of Black Pearl, and you can see that it kind of streamed that data back for me. So easy to do from the command line, a little bit harder to do from a UI because we have some choices we have to do. If we want it like this, we can use some JavaScript to basically watch for data that comes back and then display it in the UI. We can also do something like using server sent events. I'm just going to keep it simple and do this. But let's create another template. We'll call this stream.html. And instead of writing this out together, let's just go ahead and copy this in and talk about it. So again, similar thing. Now I'm not using HTMX this time because I am going to have to write some JavaScript. I am using Tailwind here. I have the same user interface, although this interface is a little bit better because it shows the user question and then the LLM's response. But what are we doing here? So we're adding an event listener. When we submit the form, we're going to get the input value for message. And what we want to do is we want to basically fetch streaming data from the server. So I tried this with just a normal fetch call, and I found that here and there, the response was basically getting cut off because we weren't catching up with it. So I asked our overlords of the AI just a quick way to do this in JavaScript to make sure we're getting all that data back, and basically we can do that with a fetch stream with retry. So what we are doing here is we're saying fetch stream with retry. We're going to call that stream endpoint and pass our message in. And what that's going to do is basically loop over that and make sure that if the response is okay, we're going to await the fetch, which is the URL. So we're basically constantly just trying to get that data back. And then we do something to process that stream, decode that so it looks nice. We get that stream data back. And then we add this message to the chatbot. So on the Spring AI side, very easy to do. If you want to do something similar to this, you can use this example on the front end. but really easy to do on the Spring AI side. So let's go ahead. Let me make sure I save this. And let's go ahead and refresh this. And let's go back here. All right, so this is our normal one that is using the index.html. Let's go over to stream.html and let's give it a question. Tell me some of the most popular programming languages, and I'll hit enter, and you see we get that user query, and now we get that streaming data back. This is a much, much better user experience for me, right? Like, I'm immediately getting some content back. I'm not waiting for all of this content to come back at once. So let's say another one. Write me a short overview of the Java programming language and what it is used for. So we're going to hit enter. Again, we start to get that immediate feedback. Java is popular and an object-oriented programming language. First released by Sun Microsystems in 1995. Man, I am old. I graduated high school around this time. But nonetheless, so this for me is a much better user experience. I like this. And again, just to kind of reiterate the point here of this particular tutorial is that Spring AI makes streaming data very easy to do. Instead of using the call method, which is a blocking call returning all the content at once, we use the stream method, and now the return type can be a flux of strings. It could be a server-side event, a flux of server-side events of streams, whatever you want it to be. There's different ways we can kind of send this data back. So, man, a lot of fun putting this together. I hope you learned something. If you did, oh man, I know what time it is, friends. Do you know what time it is? Oh, you're going to help me out, aren't you? Yes, you are. If you found some value in this, do me a big favor. Leave me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and as always, happy coding, friends.